research project is called EyesOnALZ, and the EyesOnALZ project has created an online game called Stall Catchers that anyone can play to help speed up Alzheimer's research. Stall Catchers now has over 11,000 registered users, it's, I think, drawn in a community of people of all ages, of all nationalities, who have this sort of shared interest and goal of helping to find a cure for Alzheimer's disease. So we're working with the Cornell Biomedical Research Department, and they're generating the research data. They have what looks to me to be a very promising disease model, an idea of how Alzheimer's disease works, and it's related to blood flow in the brain. And so by playing Stall Catchers, we're actually helping to analyze their research data, which helps answer questions that either supports or refutes this model. But the singular goal, I think, is to find some effective treatment for Alzheimer's disease as soon as possible so that it can help people who are living with the disease today. I'm very excited that in the not too distant future, in the next few months, we'll have our first results that actually will either support or refute possible treatment targets for Alzheimer's disease. The ethos of the project is about people coming out of the woodwork and supporting getting a cure, and everyone supports in different ways. Some people support by playing Stall Catchers, and some people support by donating money to BrightFocus, which then helps us pursue this kind of a treatment. How are we advancing this field of crowdsourcing and collective intelligence, which is really what this is about? It's about getting lots of human brains working on a problem together. I'm super excited about the work that's being done by our collaborators at Cornell University, Chris Schaefer and Izomi Nishimura, and their postdoc, Oliver Bracco. It's like no other Alzheimer's research track that I'm aware of, because they're looking at blood flow in the brain. So reduced brain blood flow has been associated with Alzheimer's disease almost since we knew about the disease, but the sort of recent advancement they made is sort of beginning to understand the mechanisms of that reduced blood flow, and actually in restoring blood flow in animal models of the disease, they've actually seen memories restored in the animals. I think once people have been involved in the process and they see the results coming out of that, and we do feedback our results to our community of volunteers, then they see the power of science and what it can do and what problems it can solve. But we're all in this together, and so let's do something about it. I think for some people it's a meditation. For a caregiver who's spending most of their waking time caring for someone with Alzheimer's disease, to be able to sit down and do something that they know is making a difference, it's not just a meditation, but it's an empowerment. It's actually kind of fun and easy to play. I think it's easy to get started, and people like it for different reasons. We have middle school students who are actively playing the game, and they're sort of competitive, and they actually care about leveling up. They walk around and tell you what level they are in the game. But then we have caregivers and even Alzheimer's patients playing the game. We have the game tuned so really anyone can play it, and there's no way to hurt the data, and anything that you contribute, all the goodness will be extracted from that. That's part of the research we do, is how to pull all the goodness out of the work that people do and be more efficient at that. Personally, I would ask people if they think it would be interesting to go to stallcatchers.com, this online game that we created, and spend a few minutes learning how to play. We have sort of an online walk-me-through tutorial that shows you how to analyze these blood vessels, and if every person who participated in World Alzheimer's Day spent 5 or 10 minutes doing this, we could probably analyze an entire data set and answer a research question about a candidate treatment for Alzheimer's disease. It would be huge.